Welcome, my dear friends. Thank you so very much for stopping by. Thank you for watching my channel, Ivana Tarot. This is astrology, this is not tarot. Full moon in the sign of Scorpio, which will happen 29th or 30th of April, depends basically where you live, 2018. So today we will talk about something very extreme, like moon in the sign of Scorpio might be. So, let's get started. Okay, my dear friends. So, moon in the sign of Scorpio, and everybody knows that, you know, everything which is, you know, whenever we talk about zodiac sign Scorpio, everything is very, 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 very intense, you know, like this music in introduction. So, moon in the sign of Scorpio, full moon in the sign of Scorpio will be intense, 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 you know. So, I even do not know, for, you know, this time, you know, how even, you know, to start. Because how to describe such a powerful, such an intense energy. And if you are very sensible, maybe you can feel already this type of energy, you know, building. And a couple of days after this full moon in the sign of Scorpio, you know, maybe you will feel like, you know, being, you know, a little bit, you know, dizzy, you know, inside of head. Everything depends how old or young you are, what is going on now in your life. Okay, first and foremost, my dear friends, you know, whenever I have a chance to record this type of video, full moon or new moon in any kind of, you know, given astrological sign, I always need to emphasize, we are all 12 zodiac signs, not every single day. I mean, everything depends on your natal chart and, you know, what type of houses basically you have fulfilled. But chart, generally speaking, zodiac wheel is a human being from the very first house of Aries, which represents the head, and the very last zodiac house, which is Pisces, which represent feet. Okay, so what is Scorpio then? What Scorpio in astrology basically represent? Sexual organs. This is what Scorpio represent. Sexual issue. Doesn't have to be issue. Simply could be, you know, having a sex. Also, taboo. Fear. Control. Not having, you know, control. Which is typical, you know, theme, subject of every single Scorpio man or woman. Can I trust you? Because if I cannot trust you, and trust in Scorpio world, this is not like, you know, plain average, you know, trust. If you deal, or maybe you already dealt, maybe you have been in a relationship with Scorpio, then you know that Scorpios are very mysterious type of people, both men and women. You cannot play with Scorpio man or woman. And even furthermore, don't do that, because Scorpio, man or woman, they tend not to forgive and even not to forget. And basically, I mean, guys, you know, try to be honest. Why should they forgive, you know, and forget if somebody play out with their trust, you know? So this is basically it. This is trust issue. This is trust issue. Also, because ruler of this full moon in the sign of Scorpio is obviously, you know, Mars and Pluto, and now they are in a conjunction. I mean, guys, I mean, you know, you need to get your power back. This is trust issue, so get your power back. Maybe this is you dealing with uncomfortable situation inside of house. Maybe this is dispute which basically is coming around this, you know, date. Of full moon with your boss, maybe this is your colleague, maybe this is your partner, is going to be intense. And, you know, so many people all around the world, you know, you will ask yourself, you know, okay, am I survive this, you know, full moon in the sign of Scorpio? Of course, honey, no doubt about that, you know, because Scorpio know how to fight, Scorpios know how to fight back. And just remember what I said to you, you know, you have Scorpio think, you have Scorpio element, Scorpio energy in your zodiac wheel as well. Also, very important, another agenda is, I mean, subject, theme, or whatever you prefer, is, now I forget what I wanted to say. trust issue, control issue, sex issue, money issue, and now at this very second I cannot recall. Believing. I have so many informations in my head, so please be patient, you know. So Moon next to Jupiter being in retrograde motion, saying, can I even believe in me? Can you believe basically in you? Jupiter, generally speaking, represents your self-esteem and belief system, and conscious part inside of you. But Jupiter is in a retrograde motion, so maybe you are surrounded with all kind of, you know, weird people, and simply this is you saying, you know, I cannot trust like to no one. And even after some time, you know, I tend to find myself, I caught myself, you know, so many times even not being able to trust in me. So maybe somebody is, you know, playing with your mind, you know. This could happen. I mean, this could happen, of course, maybe not for all of you, but for some of you this could happen. So basically, as soon as it is possible, what you need to do, because Jupiter represents higher knowledge and higher self, wisdom, and above all, the truth. So as soon as possible, find out what is the truth, you know, because only truth will set you free. And listen, inner voice inside of you, because your inner voice, your intuition, and your higher self will never play out with you. They will never, you know, you will never be wrong if you listen to your intuition. Also, there could be, you know, somebody, you know, pretending to be the very best friend, or pretending that this person, man or female, is basically the very best partner for you, you know. And maybe this person is good friend, or lover, or spouse, or partner, business partner. But you have, or vast majority of people out there, you might have this trust issue. You know, maybe somebody is good for you, but you simply cannot, you know, believe that this person basically is, you know, good for you. Also, there is somebody in your life, somebody who does not want to be on your side. I mean, this ruler of this full moon in sign of Scorpio is Mars in conjunction with the Pluto. So this is like, you know, one on one, and somebody most likely older, much more older than you, somebody saying, no, I don't want to have any kind of, you know, trouble with this person, or with you even, you know. This is not my thing, this is not my theme, this is not my problem. So maybe you'll find yourself in a problem without having your support. Can you see, this is all subject of, you know, Scorpio thing, you know. Can I rely on you? Can I trust you? You know, are you going to be next to me? Are you going to help me, you know, once, just once in lifetime? Maybe I will need you. Can I count on you? Guys, listen to me. New moon is about new beginning, obviously, you know. Full moon is not about new beginning, you know. This is, you know, setting, first of all, understanding, clearing, and setting completely new foundation. So this is culmination. So take the power. Of course, I will talk about every single zodiac sign, how you can translate this full moon, but you need to understand this introduction, because without introduction you ain't gonna understand what this type of energy basically might and will bring in your life. Okay, so fate issue, trust issue, being completely on your own, you know. Maybe this is you, single mother or single father, especially single, because this is water sign, so basically this is female energy, you know. So maybe this is you, like a single mom, like with the three kids, saying, you know, screaming, being, you know, upset because nobody is willing to help you. But honey, believe me, you will find the way, because Jupiter will help you. Jupiter is a spiritual planet. This is your higher self. All you need to do, you need to realize who is good for you, who is bad for you, and you need to be self-reliant. Listen to your intuition and you will find the way out from this messy type of situation. So, you know, this full moon in the sign of Scorpio, also this could be leaving the project, leaving love relationship, leaving something behind your back. You see, guys, you know, I mean, to have ruler of this full moon, Mars in conjunction with Pluto, and there is a Saturn also, and there is a Lilith. You know, everything is screaming, I want to be free, I want to have control, I want to have a power of my life back. So basically this is your screaming, I want to be in a control of my life. This is what it is. Okay, I think that basically I described more or less, you know, everything. So now let me talk a little bit about how this energy can play out for every single zodiac sign. And of course, we will start with Aries. So if you do belong to zodiac sign of Aries, basically how this energy of full moon in sign of Scorpio next to Jupiter in retrograde motion can play out in your life. And of course, this is your 8th house. Guys, listen to me. Try to listen not only your sun sign, please try to listen where you have moon in your natal chart explanation and your rising sun as well. So basically you need like 3 explanation and only then you will understand basically what might happen to you. Okay, Aries, this is for you. Some secrets are going to be revealed because this is basically your 8th house. Now, with this secret being revealed, you can do whatever you want. You can pretend, you know, okay, I simply do not want to know because Jupiter is in retrograde motion. Maybe this is you saying, I know that already, you know, I don't want to mess around, you know, all the same. Maybe this is you, you know, waving, you know, with your hand saying, you know, I don't care. But if you do care, then you need to do something about this secret which will be revealed in your life. Also, some money is coming. Maybe this is money coming from mother, father, grandfather, or maybe grandmother. So basically this is like, you know, somebody will leave you like a legacy, some money, maybe even could be real estate, most likely money, but also could be some house or something of that kind. Okay, Taurus, full moon in sign of Scorpio, for you this will happen in your 7th house. Now, Taurus, this is interesting. Maybe you will discover that you still have, you know, some emotions for your partner, maybe even including your first husband, you know. Maybe this is you saying, you know, I do not want to be single anymore. I rather choose, you know, I want to be in a relationship with my ex-partner as well. Okay, I mean, why not? If you want to do that, do that. Gemini's 6th house. Okay, so you need to discover what you want to do in your life. What kind of job basically you want to do. Cancers, this is your 5th house. You need to get power back over your partner. And you will get opportunity. You will get the power over your partner back. Whatever this might mean for you. Maybe you will fall in love back with your current partner. Leo, 4th house. Leos, listen to me. And I'm saying that for quite a long time, you know, your family need you. You need to put in a balance, you know, your family life and basically your career, because your family needs you. Yes, I can see your minds are on completely, somewhere else, but all I'm saying, your family needs you. Virgos, 3rd house for you. Go back to your school, simply go back. Because studying, school, any kind of course now is good for you. And please, don't wait. Expand your knowledge, as much as you can. Future seems so bright for you. But only if you have inside of your pocket this, you know, piece of paper, meaning, you know, your degree. My dear Libras, full moon in a sign of Scorpio, which will happen in the 2nd house. So money is coming somehow to you, and most likely you ain't gonna have, issues when it comes to self-esteem, because this is basically, you know, your spot and very, you know, very touchy spot. But most likely this is you building self-esteem inside of you, and most likely there is a reason. Maybe you will get dream job or something of that kind, but money is coming your way. Also, skills, talents is will be revealed to you in very awkward you know, completely weird type of situation. Scorpios, this is all about you. This is your first house. This is all about you. Now you can boost your energy. You can be proud of who you are and in your own eyes, which I think means a lot for you. You will get finally control over your actions, over your thoughts back. So future seems bright to you. So basically optimism and taking your control over you and over your life is basically a good thing. One thing more, get rid of fear, of any kind of fear. Simply believe in your life the way it is. Sagittarius, this is your 12th house. Okay, revelations of some kind coming to you. So you might find a life purpose, big, you know, surprise, which will be acknowledged, revealed to you. Most likely, maybe you will start with a new spiritual practice, something of that kind basically is possible. So big insights are coming to you. Capricorn, 11th house. Many people will seek your friendship. You will get a leading role, which obviously is coming. Do not be afraid. You need to learn how to handle properly people and big group of people. So, you know, and also one thing more, optimism, especially when it comes to love relationship and your friends, this optimism and believing in people, generally speaking, is coming back. Aquarius, 10th house. Take control of your career back, like, you know, my way. So maybe this is like angry, you know, dispute, you know, with somebody, but you need to gain power back. You will become a boss only to the due to this fact that basically you can shout, you know, saying, no, everybody will listen to me, because, you know, I'm okay. You maybe you ain't gonna use my words, I'm the smartest in this office, but basically I know, you know, the very best possible exit or solution of any kind of problem. This is your thing, and do that. Do not wait, you know. So you will change this attitude, you know. So basically you will become a boss. Pisces, 9th house, new philosophy is coming in your life. Old way of thinking finally now is gone. New approach to life, new approach even to you. And you know, if you are skilled in any kind of, you know, psychology, psychiatrist, maybe psychiatry, maybe Reiki healing, any kind of that, maybe basically you will start and in a very wise type of a way, new business, maybe even in another country, which is basically connected with spiritual practice. This is basically what I can see. So this is how you can earn more money, but only if you do trust in yourself. My dear friends, this is it, you know. A short type of a video which you can explain to you what is going on. Okay, if you want to hear your story, book a private reading with me. You will get astrology and tarot reading for the price of one. I wish you all the best. God bless you all. Make sure to subscribe on my channel and please share this video with your friends. Take care. Bye.